Yeah, good afternoon, YouTube. The tankless water heater came in today. So just checking it out here. Let's see, hot and cold water. There's your water filter. That's the condensate drain. And then down on the bottom, you got your power cord and then the gas with the yellow over there. And there's your control panel. This is the fresh air, and I think that's the exhaust vent, if I remember right. And what they do is they supply a 3-inch PVC coupler, and you can adapt that. You can put a 3 to 4 inch adapter if you want to go to 4. You can go 3 to 2. I'm just going to use 3-inch PVC since that's what my existing vent size is. And I guess the way this works is this is supposed to go inside, but this coupler, it's a maybe 20-30 thousandths too big. So what I did is I turned that side down on my lathe, because down in here there's an O-ring. That's what actually seals up. There's no hose clamps or anything on this. So I just turned this down just a tiny little bit there. So I'll show you how I'm doing the other one here. Yeah, so here's the 3-inch PVC coupling, and you can see there's these injection molding marks, and the sides aren't quite straight, and you can see the diameter difference is really small. And I was trying to file it down, but the PVC really gums up the teeth on the file, and even the sandpaper. I was trying to do that, but it you got to take off enough material. So I thought, I've got a lathe here, just chuck this up, and just to show you how much of a cut there is here. Yeah, it's not much at all, just one pass. And that makes a pretty nice finish. I'll just round off the edge with some sandpaper. About right. Yeah, that looks pretty close. Yeah, this is just far enough to bottom out in the pipe, and then the O-ring sits in about here. So let's take a look at the dimensions. Your original OD on the coupling is 3992, roughly 3991. And if we flip this over, see there, I'm about 3975. So yeah, about 15-20 thousandths. Not much at all, but boy, that just makes all the difference in the world. Yeah, you don't want it too small, but just take the skin off of it there. So that's my first little thing to do. So yeah, here's the other two pieces. These don't come with the heater, but it's really recommended that you get these. These are the service valves. So here's your cold water, and they're actually double valves, so they come with a union to go onto the bottom of the water heater. And then they've got a 3/4 inch female pipe thread on the bottom. So this would be up to the heater. This is your cold water inlet. And then this is your service valve where you can hook up a flushing kit. So the idea is you can shut off the inlet water, open up this service port, and either drain the unit or hook up a circulating pump to pump vinegar or descaling liquid in. And the same thing, here's your hot water, your inlet shutoff valve, and your service port. And then this comes with a pressure relief valve. There's a temperature relief valve up in the water heater. And I've got my drain hose. I picked that up, so that's ready to go. I'll show you the box over here. Yeah, so here's the box that came in, the Takagi. There's the part number, the H3MDV, natural gas. And if it should have, yeah, there we go. This one does have the 1/2 inch pipe thread. There's your 3/4 inch on the water. And 1/2 inch on the gas, so that's the unit I wanted. And then there's your 1/2 inch condensate drain right there. 3/4 on the hot and the cold. half on the gas, and then 120 volts AC plug, and then I think inside is where the remote control enters. There is the water heater. It's about 50 pounds. Yeah, that looks pretty good. It was deeper than I thought. It's hard to tell how deep these are because it's 6 inches from here to the center, and then you've got about another probably 4 more inches out here. So there we go. Brand new Takagi tankless water heater. Yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put the next videos over here on the side as we get this thing installed this weekend. And as always, thanks for watching.